ॐ भूर्भुवः स्वः तत्सवितुर्वरेण्यं भर्गोदेवस्य धीमहि धियो यो नः प्रचोदयात्। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। नमस्कार माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एम गोइंग टू मेक अ वीडियो ऑन तत्वबोधा ऑफ आदि शंकराचार्य। तत्वबोधा गिव्स द मीनिंग ऑफ फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ अद्वैता वेदांता। सो टू अंडरस्टैंड अद्वैत वेदांता वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड द बेसिक्स, द इंट्रोडक्टरी एंड फंडामेंटल नॉलेज ऑफ अद्वैत वेद अद्वैता वेदांत। सो आई स्टार्ट अद्वैता वेदांत। तत्वबोधा, तत्वबोधा इज एन इंट्रोडक्टरी टेक्स्ट आउटलाइनिंग द फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ वेदांत। ब्रीफली एंड इन सिंपल लैंग्वेज इट डील्स विद द नॉलेज और रियलिटी, the individual and the world and the relationship between them. It also describes the qualifications of the student. Tattva Bodha is a Prakarana Grantha that introduces the concepts and terminology later to be found in Vedanta. It is composed for a new student who has to understand the technical terms before the study of actual textbooks is undertaken. The text is composed in the form of a dialogue between the teacher and the disciple. Invocation. Vasudev Yandra Yogindram Natva Gyan Pradam Gurum Mumukshunam Hitarthaye Tatva Bodho Bhidhiyate. Having saluted Sri Vasudeva, the king of yogis, the guru who is the bestower of jnana, the knowledge of the truth, the tattva bodha, the knowledge of the truth, is expounded for the benefit of the seekers after liberation. By this stanza, Shankara salutes the Lord Sri Vasudeva, who is the Gitacharya and hence the guru and bestower of knowledge, who is also the Yogeshwara Yogindra. It also serves as salutations to his personal guru Sri Govinda Bhagavata Pada. Govinda being a synonym for Vasudeva. This stanza also indicates the Anubandha Chatustaya, namely the Adhikari, Visaya, Sambandha and Prayojana, which are generally given at the commencement of such treaties. Here the Adhikari is the Mumukshu, the seeker after liberation. Visaya is Tatvabodha, the knowledge of the Tattva or Truth. Sambandha is the relation between the thing to be known and that which tells of it. Here the vastu to be known is Brahma and the tattva bodha is that which speaks of it. Prayojana or the benefit, phala, is mumukshu nam hita or the fulfillment of the desire for liberation of the seeker. With this we get into the text proper. Sadhan chatushta sampanna adhikarinam मोक्ष साधन भूतम तत्व विवेक प्रकारम वक्षामः। वी विल नाउ एक्सप्लेन फॉर दोज हु आर एंडोड विद द फोर फोल्ड क्वालिफिकेशंस साधना चतुष्टया, द मोड ऑफ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन विच इज द मीन्स ऑफ लिबरेशन। फॉर लिबरेशन और अचीविंग परफेक्शन द प्रोसेस ऑफ डिस्क्रिमिनेशन शुड बी एम्प्लॉयड। The truth is mixed up with or confused with untruth and therefore a discriminative enquiry, viveka, is needed. This enquiry and associated efforts will yield Successful results only if the student is qualified. A student is considered qualified if he possesses the fourfold imperatives or qualifications. Sadhana Chatushtaya. The textbook describes this process of discriminative inquiry. Sadhana Chatushtaya. The fourfold qualifications. Sadhan Chatushtayam Kim. What are the fourfold qualifications? Nitya Anitya Vastu Vivekaha. The capacity to discriminate between the permanent and the impermanent. Iha Mutrarth Phal Bhog Viragaha. Dispassion to the enjoyment of the fruits of one's actions here and hereafter. Samadhi Satrak Sampatti. The group of six accomplishments beginning with Sama. Mumukstavam Cheti. The yearning for liberation. Viveka. Discrimination. Nitya Nitya Vastu Vivekaha Ka. What is meant by the discrimination between the eternal and the ephemeral? Means temporary. Nitya Vastu Vekam Brahma Tadvyati Riktam Sarvamini Tvam Amev Nitya Anitya Vastu Vivekaha. Brahma alone is the one Nitya Vastu. The eternal factor, everything else is anitya, that is impermanent. This conviction is the discrimination between the eternal and the ephemeral. Viveka, or discrimination between the eternal and ephemeral, the permanent and the impermanent, is the conviction that Brahma alone is the eternal factor, nitya vastu, and everything else is ephemeral, anitya, temporary, or bound by time. Time is a product of mind, and because Brahma transcends the mind, Brahma is not bound by time. It should be noted that the student at this point does not know what Brahma is. He only has the conviction of its truth and ability to reject what is impermanent. A Viveki is the one who is keenly alive to the problem of imperfection and the one who has a clear vision. Second, Vairagya, dispassion. Viragaha ka, what is dispassion? Isavrag bhogesu ichhara hitayam. The absence of desire for the enjoyment of the fruits of one's actions in this world as also in the other world. Vairagya is the absence, rahitam, of the desire to enjoy even the fruits of one's own efforts, not only in this life but hereafter. This vairagya or dispassion should arise out of discrimination rather than despair. It is a natural result of vigorous discrimination by which the seeker recognizes that the pleasures resulting from material gains are impermanent. Satka Sampatti. Sampadi Sadhan Sampatti Ka. What are the accomplishments of sadhana starting with Sama? Samo Dham Uparam Ti Tiksha Shardha Samadhanam Cha Iti. They are Sama, Dham, Uparma, Ti Tiksha, Shardha and Samadhana. The six accomplishments of sadhana are Sama, Dham, Uparma or Uparti, Titiksha, Shraddha and Samadhana. By accomplishing these qualifications, the seeker develops an integrated personality needed for spiritual development. Sama, Sama ka. What is Sama? Mano Nigraha, control or mastery over the mind. Sama is the mastery or control over one's mind. When one's mind does not pose a problem or when one stops being overwhelmed by emotion, then one has acquired Sama. Mind is a force that is meant to be at one's command, but most people get overwhelmed by the mind instead. This situation leads to regrets and frustration. Control of the mind, Mano Nigraha, is the first step in the spiritual pursuit. Dama, Dama Kaha. What is Dama? Chakshura Diba Indriyah Nigraha. Control of the external sense organs such as the eyes, etc. Dama is the control of the external senses of perception and action. This is again a natural outcome of Sama, but in case one has not achieved sufficient controls of one's mind, Dama is still helpful because response of the mind is eventually expressed by the senses. Control of senses is called Indriya Nigraha. Uparma or Uparati, Uparmahaka. What is Uparma? Savdharma Anushthan Mevaha. Strict observance of one's own dharma duty. Uparma is defined as the strict observance of one's dharma, Savdharma. Thus, a man has duty towards himself, the parents, teacher, family, society, etc. Performance of duty. Dharma usually involves sacrifice as opposed to rights, which involves demands. Titiksha. Titiksha ka. What is titiksha? Sito ushunam sukdam khadi sahishunutvam. The endurance of heat and cold, pleasure and pain, etc. Titiksha is that frame of mind in which one is able to endure heat and cold, pleasure and pain, and such other opposites of which the life consists. Vagaries of life will definitely subject one to different conditions which are pleasant as well as unpleasant. One who has a happy frame of mind and accepts things as they are has achieved titiksha. Accepting things or situations with either grudge or helplessness is titiksha. Shraddha. Shraddha ki dashi. What is the nature of Shraddha? Guru Vedanta Vakya Dishu Vishwasaha Shraddha. Faith in the words of the Guru and in the scriptures is Shraddha. Shraddha is an unqualified faith in the teacher and the scriptures. Sometimes what the teacher or the scriptures state may not be clear or appear appropriate, but the student should have faith in the validity of the statements, and he should reflect and analyze with a faith that this will lead to a proper understanding. As Gita says, Shardhavan labhate jnanam. He who has a Shardha gains knowledge. The teacher and the scriptures always say the same thing, but sometimes the teacher amplifies or supplements the scriptural statements to suit the level of the student. Samadhana. Samadhanam kim. What is samadhana? Chittaik akagrata. Chittaik akagrata. Single pointedness of the mind. Samadhana is the single pointedness of the mind, so that the mind is absorbed in a chosen flow of thoughts related to and leading up to a given topic or subject. This is called Sajatiya Virti Parvaha. Everyone has the quality of Samadhana or ability to concentrate in the subject of one's interest. So, the student of Vedanta should have his mind totally absorbed in study, reflection, and contemplation of the teaching of scriptures. The six sub-qualifications known as Satka Sampatti have thus been described briefly. The fourth qualification of the sadhana, Chatushtaya, is Mumukshutvam. that is described the law. Mumukshutvam, mumukshutvam kim? What is mumukshutvam? Moksho me bhriyad iti iccha. Let me attain moksha, liberation. This intense yearning is mumukshutvam, mumukshutvam. The intense desire for liberation is called mumukshutvam. It is compared to the desire for jumping into a pond of a man whose matted hair has caught fire. The burning desire to solve the problem of incompleteness or limitations is mumukshutvam. Mumukshutvam. This is the fundamental qualification, and other qualifications will follow if one possesses this burning desire. Moksha is not one of the objectives of a mumukshu, but the only object. Etat sadhan chatushtayam. These are the fourfold qualifications. Tattastva vivekshadha adhikaranno bhavantu. Thereafter, that is, after having acquired these fourfold qualifications, they become adhikaris, that is, persons fit for the inquiry into the truth. These are four qualifications, sadhana chatushtayam, of a seeker of truth. The student who has acquired these qualifications become an adhikari for discriminative inquiry into the truth. Nothing else such as caste, creed, sex, etc. matters. Tattva viveka, inquiry into truth. The teacher next indicates the nature of the inquiry, viveka, into the truth, that is tattva. Tattva viveka ka. What is the tattva viveka? Atma satyam tadanta sarvam mithyeti. Atma alone is real, all things other than that are unreal. This firm conviction is called tattva viveka. Truth is defined as that which remains unchanged in the three periods of time, past, present and future. It is called satyam, that which is non-existent, such as the horns of a man is called asatya, that which exists but undergoes changes or modifications during the three periods of time is called mithya, that is untrue. Everything in the objective world undergoes modifications, and so the world jagat falls in the category of mithya. The entire existence with respect to an individual can be divided into two categories. First, I or aham, and second, this or idam. Atma is the I, aham, and rest of the world is this idam. But due to the ignorance of my real nature, I am always identified with either the body or the mind or the intellect, and so I have a false notion about myself. This false notion is the ego. If I can clearly distinguish what is different from myself, I can negate it and come to apprehend my own nature. Tattva viveka is the inquiry into my real nature by first identifying what is not I or anatma, and then asserting what my real nature is. The principle employed in this inquiry is the knower or the perceiver is different from the known or the perceived. I, the knower, is different from this, the known. The following analysis shows how I, the knower, is different from the body with which I am falsely identified. This analysis is carried out from different aspects from which the human personality and existence can be viewed. Subsequently, the real nature of Atma is also pointed out. Atma kaha. What हु इज आत्मा, स्थूल सूक्ष्म कारण शरीरादय व्यक्तिरिक्त पंचकोशा अतीत सन अवस्था त्रय साक्षी सच्चिदानंद स्वरूप सन यस्तिष्ठ आत्मा दैट विच इज अदर देन द स्थूला सूक्ष्म एंड कारणा शरीराद दैट इज ग्रॉस सटल एंड कॉजल बॉडीज विच इज बियॉन्ड द फाइव सीट्स विच इज द विटनेस ऑफ थ्री स्टेट्स ऑफ अवेयरनेस विच इज द नेचर ऑफ सत्य चित आनंदा एग्जिस्टेंस नॉलेज ब्लिस इज आत्मा द फाइव सीट्स पंचकोशा In one analysis, the personality of an individual is considered to consist of five seeds, panchakosha. These are annamaya kosha, pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, anandamaya kosha. The physical body or the anatomical structure is called sthula sarira because it is a product of and is nourished by food. It is also called annamaya kosha. Annamaya modifications of food, kosha means sheath. Internal physiological functions of the body which take place because of prana are grouped as pranamaya kosha. The next level of awareness is the mind, manas, which is the seat of moods and emotions. The projections of the mind are called manomaya kosha. Intellect is the faculty by which one is conscious of one's knowledge and accomplishments. The intellect is called the vijnanamaya kosha. An individual knows certain things in life while he is ignorant of the rest. In the deep sleep state, every individual experiences the same state of bliss because the mind and intellect are not functioning with the accompanying problems and miseries. The deep sleep state is called Anandamaya Kosha. I am aware of the physical body, the prana, the mind, the intellect, and the ignorance with respect to my own personality. This means that I cannot be any one of these. That is, I am other than the five seeds. I am panchakosha atita. Sariratraya, the three bodies. The five seats can also be divided into three bodies or costumes designated as sarira. The gross body or annamaya kosha is called sthula sarira. The pranamaya, manomaya and vijnanamaya kosha are together called the subtle body, sukshma sarira. And the anandamaya kosha is called the causal body, karana sarira. Just as I am not any of the five seats, I am none of the three bodies but distinct from them. I am sthula, sukshma, karana, sarira, vijaya, trikta. Avasthatraya, the three states. The total existence of a human being is divided into three states. Avastha of consciousness, waking, dream and deep sleep. During the waking state, I am aware of the body and the mind and with their help, I am aware of the physical world as well as my thoughts and emotions. This is the waking state or Jagrat Avastha. In the dream, I am unaware of the body but have identified with the mind with the help of which a whole new world of things and beings is created, projected. The dream state is as real with respect to the dreamer as the waking state is with respect to the waker. The dream state is called Swapna Avastha. In the deep sleep state, I am not even conscious of my mind. I am as if ignorant of my existence. I am in an unmanifest state during deep sleep condition, but the memories and other traits of personality are regained when I wake up. This state is called Susupti Avastha. Upon analysis, it is evident that I, Aham or Atma cannot be the waker because the waker is absent during the dream state. Similarly, the Atma cannot be the dreamer because the dreamer is non-existent in the deep sleep condition. The Atma is therefore the common factor which is present during all the three states. He is a witness to all the states by identifying with either the sthula, sukshma or karana. Sarira, the Atma seems to be acting as the waker, the dreamer or the sleeper, just as a crystal assumes the color of the flower placed near it, or an actor who takes different roles during a drama. Like an actor, Atma is distinct from the roles it appears to be assuming. Atma is therefore called the witness of the three states of consciousness or avastha traya shakshi. Satya chit ananda swarupa. Existence, knowledge, bliss. If Atma is none of the five seats nor any of three bodies, then what is it? It is the awareness by which I am aware of all the koshas and shariras, and which is the witness of all the three states of existence. The awareness is called chitta or the knowledge. The Atma does not undergo any change during the three states nor during the passage of time because it is beyond time. It is therefore called satya or ever existent. The Atma is also beyond these limitations of the body, mind and intellect, and because space, time, etc. are the creations of mind, it is beyond space and time also. It is in a constant state of bliss or ananda. Atma is therefore called Satya Chit Ananda or existence, knowledge, bliss. It is the principle that is self-effulgent, that encompasses or pervades everything including space, and which is complete or purana. Apnoti Sarvam Iti Atma. The Satya Chit Ananda Swarupa is the natural state of every living being, but it is not experienced because we are struggling and spending all our energies after a problem that is illegitimate. The struggle of a human being can be traced to be in the fulfillment of three basic desires. Number one, to be immortal, or at least push the death as far away as possible to live a day more. Second, to gain happiness or freedom from limitations and incompleteness. And third, to acquire objective knowledge because he cannot stand ignorance. The problem of mortality, incompleteness and ignorance is in actuality an illegitimate problem because man is complete and perfect. However, the apparent problems are created because of the identification of the self with body, prana, mind, etc. There is further identification with family, society, etc. These identifications change with the time. For example, when one feels hungry, one is primarily identified with the prana, while during emotional experiences, one is identified with the mind. The false identification is the root cause of the problem. In reality, I am that principle by which I am aware of my knowledge as well as ignorance. This is the awareness or knowledge, chitto. The concept of time gives rise to the problems of birth, death, etc. However, time is not an absolute concept but a relative one because it is a projection of the mind. Thus, while going through an unpleasant experience, Time seems to be moving very slowly while the reverse occurs during a pleasant experience. The awareness is free from this relative concept of time and therefore it is free from birth, death, etc., which occur in the realm of time. The Atma is timeless or eternal, Sat or ever present. Happiness as we define it is also a state of the mind and therefore relative and variable with respect to time and place. A toy that makes a child very happy loses its value when the child grows to be a boy. A real experience of happiness occurs when one is with oneself. An object in itself cannot provide happiness. In the deep sleep state, when one is unaware of body and the mind, happiness or bliss is experienced, which is the natural state of man. The Atma is always in the state of bliss or ananda, and that is also the natural state of the human being. Thus, the timelessness, Sat or existence, awareness or knowledge, Chit, and bliss, happiness, Ananda is the natural state of man. This natural state of Atma is therefore called existence, knowledge, bliss or Sat Chit Ananda or Sat Chidananda. 3. Sthula, Sukshma, Karna, Shariras, Sharira Traya. After stating that Atma is other than the three bodies and the five seats and that it is the witness of the three states of consciousness, the teacher next proceeds to explain in detail what each of these terms means. Sthula Sharira. Sthula Shariram Kim. What is the Sthula Sharira? The gross body. Pachi Krit Pach Mahabhutai Kirtam Satkaram Janyam Sukh Dukhadi Bhogayatanam Shariram Asti Jayate Vardate Viparinimate Apik Pakshiyate Vinasatiti Sadvikar Veda Sthula Shariram. That which is composed of the five Mahabhutas, elements, after they have undergone the process of Panchi Karna, born as a result of good actions of the past, the tenement to earn the experience of Sukh, Dukh and the like, and subject to the six modifications, namely, is born, grows, changes, decays and dies, is the gross body. The Sthula Sharira or the gross body is that which is composed of five great elements, viz. Space, Akasha, air, Vayu, fire, Agni, water, Apaha and earth, Prithvi. The gross body is created by the grossification, Panchi Karna of these elements. The volume of the body occupies space, the breathing and the respiratory system is due to air, the warmth in the body is due to fire, and the body is made up of water and the mineral earth. This physical body in human form is considered to be acquired as a result of good deeds in the past, Sat Karma Janya. This body is also the hutment or the counter for experiencing pleasure, pain, etc. It is subject to disintegration and is also subject to the six modifications, Sattvikara. These modifications are existence, astitva, birth, janma, growth, vardhana, maturity, viparnima, decay, apakshaya, and death, vinasha. Sukshma sharira. Sukshma shariram kim. What is this sukshma sharira? The subtle body. Apanchi krit panch mahabhutai kirtam satkaram janyam. Sukh dukhadi bhog sadhanam panch gyanindriyani panchah karmendriyani panch pranadaya manchai kaim buddhishtvayaka evam sapt dasakalabhisa yatishtati tat suksam shariram. that which is composed of five Mahabhutas, elements prior to their undergoing the process of Panchikarana, born of good actions of the past, the instruments for the experiences of pleasure, pain, etc., constituted of the 17 items, namely the 5 Gyanendriyas, sense organs, the 5 Karmendriyas, the organs of action, the 5 Pranas, Prana, Apana, Udana, Samana, and Vyana, the mind and the intellect is the subtle body. While the gross body consists of the external hatment and the internal gross physiological systems, the subtle body is the counterpart that keeps the gross body alive, performs all the physiological functions, and operates the organs of action and perception. The physical body dies when the subtle body departs. The subtle body consists of 17 components. These are the 5 organs of perception, the 5 organs of action, the 5 pranas, the mind, manas, and the intellect, buddhi. The senses of perception and actions are not the gross external organs. These are included in the gross body, but they are subtle counterparts which actually operate the gross body. The subtle body varies from body to body and from one form to the other. That is, for example, animal, etc. And therefore, every individual is a unique entity. The subtle body is composed of the 5 great elements, but before their grossification, they are called the tanmatras. It is also acquired as a result of good deeds in the past. It is the instrument of experience as against the gross body, which is the counter or hatment of pleasure, pain, etc. Next is Gyanendriyas, organs of perception. Srotram tavak chakshu rasna granam iti panch gyanendriyani. Ear, skin, sense of touch, eyes, tongue, sense of taste, and nose, smell. These are the 5 Gyanendriyas, organs of perception. Srotrasah Diggadevata, the presiding deity of the ear is space. Tavacho Vayu, of the skin, touch the air. Chakshu Surya, of the eyes, the sun. Rasanaya Varuna, of the tongue, taste Varuna, the principle of water. Granas Asvino, of the smell, knows the Asmini Kumara's twins. Iti Gyanendriya Devata, thus the aforesaid are the presiding deities of the organs of perception. Srotra Sah Visaya Sabda Grahanam, the field of experience for the ear is the reception of sound. Tavacho Visaya Sparsha Grahanam, for the skin the field of experience is the cognition of touch. Chakshu So Visaya Rupa Grahanam, for the eyes the field of experience is the perception of forms. Rasnaya Visaya Ras Grahanam, for the tongue the field of experience is the cognition of taste. Grahanasya Visaya Gandha Grahanam Iti, and of the nose the field of experience is the cognition of smell. Karmendriyas, organs of action. Vak Pani Pad Payo Sathaniti Panch Karmendriyani. Speech, hands, legs, anus, and the genitals are the 5 Karmendriyas, the organs of action. Vacho Devata Vanyahi, the presiding deity for speech is fire. Hastandriindra, of the hands, Indra. Padyo Vishnu, of the feet, Vishnu. Payor Mirtu, of the anus, the organ of excretion, Mirtu, the lord of death. For the genitals, Prajapati, उपस्थस्य प्रजापति इति कर्मेंद्रिय देवता दस द प्रिजाइडिंग डीटीज फॉर द ऑर्गन्स ऑफ एक्शन वाचो विषय भाषणम द फंक्शन ऑफ द ऑर्गन ऑफ स्पीच इज टू स्पीक पाणयो विषय वस्तु ग्रहणम द फंक्शन ऑफ द हैंड्स इज टू ग्रास्प थिंग्स पादयो विषय गमनम द फंक्शन ऑफ द लेग्स इज लोकोमोशन पायोर्विषय मलत्याग द फंक्शन ऑफ द एनस एक्सक्रेटरी ऑर्गन इज द एलिमिनेशन ऑफ द वेस्ट प्रोडक्ट्स उपस्थस्य विषय आनंद इति द फंक्शन ऑफ द जेनिटल ऑर्गन इज प्लेजर प्रोक्रिएशन कारण शरीरम कॉजल बॉडी कारण शरीरम किम व्हाट इज द कॉजल बॉडी अनिर्वाचने विद्यारूपम शरीरद्वयमस्य कारणमात्रम सत्स्वरूप ज्ञानम निर्विकल्पकरूपम यदस्ति तत्कारण शरीरम दैट विच इज द इनएक्सप्लिकेबल बिगिनिंगलेस एंड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अविद्या ignorance of reality the cause for the other two bodies the subtle and the gross ignorant of one's own real nature self free from duality or division is the karana sharira or the causal body a man in deep sleep experiences a happiness or bliss ananda resulting from the absence of identification with the body and the mind during this state one is completely ignorant of anything that is one has an experience of nothing in particular during deep sleep one is under the influence of or identified with the causal body during this state one is free from the dualities created by the gross and the subtle bodies and therefore this state is described as a nirvikalpa or devoid of qualifications the causal body is indescribable anirvachaniya or inexplicable because this state of ignorance is neither sat existing in all the three periods of time nor asat non existent the causal body is also called avidya rupam because the ignorance of which it consists is opposed to the subjective knowledge the ignorance of the real self results in the error of one's assuming oneself to be incomplete and identifying with the gross and the subtle bodies it is therefore also responsible for or cause for the creation of the gross and the subtle bodies because of the ignorance one is unaware of one's real self and is not able to experience the satya chit ananda swarupa avastha traya the three states after the discussion of the gross subtle and the causal bodies the three states of consciousness are described avastha trayam kim what are the three states of experience jagrat swapan susupta avastha they are the waking the dream and the deep sleep states jagrat avastha waking state जागृत अवस्था का व्हाट इज द वीकिंग स्टेट श्रोत्रादि ज्ञान इंद्रियः शब्दादि विषयश्च ज्ञायते इति यत् सा जागृत अवस्था स्थूल शरीराभिमानी आत्मा विश्व इत्युच्यते द स्टेट ऑफ एक्सपीरियंस इन विच द सेंस ऑब्जेक्ट्स साउंड एटसेट्रा आर perceived through the sense organs ear etc is the waking state the self identifying itself with the gross body is called viswa the self identified with the gross body is in the waking state in this state man perceives the world of objects with the help of organs of perception and gains experience of objects with sound touch form taste and smell during this state all the faculties are operating and the individual is in a complete form viswa the subtle and causal bodies are also available for experience during the waking state swapna avastha dream state स्वप्ना अवस्था केति चेत जागृत अवस्थायां यद् दृष्टं यद् श्रुतं तज्जनि तवासन या निद्रा समय यह प्रपंच प्रतीयते स्वप्नावस्था सूक्ष्म शरीराभिमानी आत्मा तेजस्य इत्युच्यते। फॉर द क्वेश्चन व्हाट इज स्वरूपा अवस्था ऑफ द ड्रीम स्वप्ना अवस्था ऑफ द ड्रीम स्टेट द एक्सप्लेनेशन इज द वर्ल्ड दैट इज प्रोजेक्टेड वाइल्ड इन स्लीप फ्रॉम द इम्प्रेशंस बोर्न ऑफ व्हाट हैज बीन सीन और हर्ड इन द वेकिंग स्टेट इज कॉल्ड ड्रीम द सेल्फ आइडेंटिफाइंग इटसेल्फ विद द सटल बॉडी इज कॉल्ड तेजसा। The dream state is that in which the self is identified with the mind subtle body. During this state, the mind projects a whole new objective world based on the impressions, vasanas it has gained while hearing, seeing, etc. in the waking state. The waker dies entirely in order that the dreamer is born. These two states cannot exist simultaneously. We cannot experience in the dream what we have not seen, heard, or thought of during the waking state. It is possible that several impressions may get mixed up to create objects or experiences during the dream impressions that are unreal from the waker's standpoint. The self identified with the subtle body during the dream state is called Tejasa. The whole world is luminous with thoughts alone. The objects experienced during dream do not have objective reality. Susupti avastha, deep sleep state. Atah susupti avastha ka. Then what is the deep sleep state? अहम किमपि न जानामि सुखेन मया निद्रा अनुभूयतः इति सुसुप्तेह अवस्था। दैट स्टेट About which one says that later I did not know anything, I have well enjoyed a good sleep is the deep sleep state. Karan sarira bhimani atma praga itu chayate. The self identifying itself with the causal body in the deep sleep state is called prajana, prayana, ajana, that is almost ignorant. A man gains particular experience during the waking and the dream states. In the dream sleep state, however, there is no particular experience. The sleeper does not know anything during this state, that is to say, he is ignorant, but he is also free from the limitations of the gross and the subtle bodies, and so he is in a state of bliss, ananda. The self is ignorant of this bliss as the mind is absent. The consciousness or the awareness, Atma, is however present in this state so that when the sleeper wakes up, he has the memory of a happy sleep and he also regains the past memories before he went to sleep. The Atman maintains a continuity of existence and memories. During the deep sleep state, the self is identified with the causal body. During this state, it is only aware of the thought, I don't know. The self in this state is designated as prajna, meaning the one who is nearly ignorant. Because the consciousness is present during this state, the self is not totally ignorant, but nearly ignorant. The three states of consciousness have thus been described. From the description, it is evident that the self is identified with one of the three bodies at any one time and so is called differently during these states. However, the self is the same and ever present in each state and is therefore called the witness or sakshi. Panchakosa. The Panchakosa or the five seats are described next. Panchakosa ki. What are the five seats? Anmaya, pranamaya, manomayam, vijnanamaya, anandamaya has cheti. The food seat, the vital air seat, the mental seat, the intellectual seat and the bliss seat are the five seats. A kosha does not really indicate a covering because the all-pervading Atma cannot be covered by the limited gross matter. Kosha means the universal error due to identification resulting from ignorance. It appears as if Atma is covered by a sheath. Annamaya kosha, food sheath. Annamaya, what is the food sheath? That which is born of food, which grows by food and goes back to earth, which is of the nature of food, is called the food seat. This is the gross body. The gross body is designated as Annamaya kosha or the food seat. It is so called because the body is born out of the products of food eaten by the parents. It subsequently grows due to and is maintained by the modification of food, and on death disappears into the earth to eventually become food. The identification of the self with gross body creates the appearance of the food seat. The suffix maya in annamaya means vikara or modification. Thus, annamaya means that which is made of the modification of food. The same meaning of the suffix maya applies to the next three koshas, pranam, manah, and vijnana. Pranamaya kosha or vital air seat. Pranamaya kya? What is the vital air seat? Pranadya pancha vayava vaga dindriya pancha kamah prana kosha. The five physiological functions such as prana, etc., prana, apana, vyana, udana, and samana, together with the five organs of action, namely speech, etc., form the pranamaya kosha, the vital air seat. The five physiological functions in the body, together with the five organs of action, are known as the pranamaya kosha. The identification of the self with the functions of the prana, that is, I am hungry, thirsty, etc., has the effect of causing the vital air seat. The self mistakes himself to be the prana. The five physiological functions of prana are as follows. Prana, respiration. Apana, evacuation or rejection. Vyana, circulation. Udana, reaction, throwing out. Samana, assimilation, digestion. Udana stands for the reaction from within the body. For example, vomiting, tears, etc. It becomes active at the time of death. The five organs of actions are also included in the pranamaya kosha. Manamaya kosha, mental seat. Manomaya kosha ka. What is the mental seat? Manasya jnanendriya panchakam militva yo bhavati sa manomaya kosha. The mind and the five organs of perception together form the mental sheath. Mind is the faculty which receives stimuli from the outer world through the organs of perception. It is also the sheath of emotions and feelings. The mind together with the five organs of perception constitute the manomaya kosha. The identification of the self with these functions creates the appearance of a mental seat. That is, I am happy, unhappy, angry, etc. Vijnanamaya kosha, intellectual seat. Vijnanamaya ka. What is the intellectual seat? Buddhi jnanendriya panchakamah militva yo bhavati sa vijnanamaya kosha. The intellect along with the five organs of perception together form the intellectual seat. The intellect is the deciding faculty as well as that which creates a sense of doership, amkara. The mind and the intellect are really two aspects of the same thinking faculty. The same faculty when feeling emotions or vacillating is called mind. It is called intellect when it determines or decides something. The nature of the intellect is cognition as against volition of the mind. The intellect together with the five organs of perception form the intellectual seat. I am the knower, doer, etc. Anandamaya kosha, bliss seat. Anandamaya ka. What is the bliss seat? Ev nev karan sarir bhutati vidya sathal manis tvavam प्रियादि वृत्ति सहितम सत आनंदमय कोशा एस्टेब्लिश्ड इन अविद्या विच इज ऑफ द फॉर्म ऑफ द कॉजल बॉडी ऑफ इन प्योर नेचर विच इज ऑफ द फॉर्म ऑफ द कॉजल बॉडी ऑफ इन प्योर नेचर यूनाइटेड विद द वृत्तिज मॉडिफिकेशन लाइक प्रिया मोदा एंड प्रामोदा द इग्नोरेंस एंड द ब्लिस एक्सपीरियंस्ड by a person during the deep sleep state constitute the anandamaya kosha. The suffix maya is used here in the sense of saturation or preponderance rather than modification as in other seats. One is not aware of the gross and the subtle bodies during this state, but the existence is filled with virtis, thought modifications like Priya, Moda and Pramoda virtis indicate the intensity of joy experienced by a person. Priya virti is the joy felt at the thought of an object one likes. Moda is the joy felt when the object is possessed. Pramoda is the joy of experiencing the desired object. The bliss state is the same as the causal body. Etat kosha panchakam. These are the five seats. Thus, each of the five seats apparently covers Atma, which is not perceived in its true nature because of identification with the elements corresponding to the seats. It is not that the five seats are progressive, that is, one is inside the other, and so on. Each of the seats independently covers the Atma depending upon whether the I is identified with the body or the mind or the intellect, etc. At any given time, the five seats designate the five common universal errors, not considering the errors that people commit because of identification with the family, society, etc. Panchakosha Atita. Atma is described as Panchakosha Atita. That is, one who transcends all the five seats. It is not identified with any of them, but is present in each of them. मदीयं शरीरं मदीया प्राणा मदीयं मनश्च मदीया बुद्धिर्मदीयं ज्ञानमति सवनेन ज्ञायते तद्धा मदीयत्वेन ज्ञातं कटककुंडला ग्रहादिकं सर्वसमादिन्नस्तथा पंचकोशादिकं स्वप्नादिदं मदीयत्वेन ज्ञातं आत्मानं भवति. Just as bangles, earrings, houses, etc., known as mine, are all other than the knower, so to the five seats known by the self as my body, pranas, my mind, my intellect, and my knowledge should all be other than the knower, and so cannot be the Atma. The knower is always different from the known, just as the personal belongings such as bangles, earrings, house, etc. are also known by me and are therefore different from me. It is only when I identify myself with these seats that I become linked by them. For example, if I identify myself with the house, my mobility is greatly restricted. When I identify with the body, the limitations of the body are mine. Similarly, the emotions of the mind and the ignorance of the intellect. So, my dear friend, these are the basics we must understand and know. We must clearly understand the difference between stool body, that is gross body, subtle bodies, that is Sukshma Sarira, and causal body, that is Karan Sarira. And we must understand five pranas and what are five organs of perception and five organs of action. So these are the very basic things we should know, because they will be very helpful when we go deeper in the study of Vedanta, Advaita Vedanta. So it is very good. So my dear friends, please Share these videos to your friends, family members, your children, because they will help them to understand. And like, comment and share the videos and subscribe the channel. I again and again request all my dear friends, let us preserve our Sanatana Dharma, because there are people who are trying to sabotage our Sanatana Dharma. Because during the slavery period for 900 years, our Sanatana Dharma was sabotaged, and many wonderful granthas, literature was destroyed by the foreigners. So let us try to preserve this. So thank you for watching this video. Please, namaskar, my dear friends, namaskar.